Hello, it's me, Kavita Isnayar, faculty of Silver Hills Public School, CBSE, Handling Mathematics. Today, let us deal with integration. Integrals are of two forms. One is definite integral and the other is indefinite integral. These both together constitute the integral calculus. Today let us go through some standard forms of integration. Integral 1 by ax square plus bx plus c dx and integral 1 by root of ax square plus bx plus c dx. Now, let us do one example of first type. Consider integral 1 by x square minus 6x plus 13 dx equal to integral. The denominator which you are seeing x square minus 6x plus 13 has to be made into a perfect square. For that, we have to take the middle half of the middle term and take the square, add, subtract. That is 1 by x square minus 6x, half of 6 is 3. So 3 square is added, 3 square subtracted plus 13 dx. This part is a perfect square. So equal to integral 1 by x minus 3 whole square, then comes minus 9 plus 13. Minus 9 plus 13 is 4. So equal to 1 by x minus 3 whole square plus 4. It can be written as integral 1 by x minus 3 whole square plus 2 square dx. So this x minus 3 can be substituted as t. Differentiating with respect to x, 1 will be equal to dt by dx. So, dx will be equal to dt. So, after this, we can change to the variable. So, it will become equal to integral dt divided by t square plus 2 square. Now, we shall take the standard result. Formulae 1 by x square plus a square dx, which is equal to 1 by a tan inverse x by a plus c. So in the place of x comes t and in the place of a comes 2. So it can be written as 1 by a, that means 2, then comes tan inverse of t divided by 2 plus c equal to 1 by 2 tan inverse, instead of t, the substitution was x minus 3, so x minus 3 by 2 plus c. This is the answer. Now let us do the next question. Integral 1 by 3x square plus 13x minus 10 dx. You have to make the denominator perfect square. For that, the 3 has to be taken outside, the coefficient of x square. So integral 1 by 3 into x square plus 13 by 3x minus 10 by 3 dx. Now the half of 13 by 3, that is 13 by 6. Its square has to be added and subtracted, equal to integral 1 by, this 1 by 3 can be taken outside, this 3 can be taken outside, x square plus 13 by 3x plus 13 by 6 whole square minus 13 by 6 whole square, then the remaining minus 10 by 3 dx equal to 1 by 3 integral 1 divided by, this part is a perfect square, so we can write x plus 13 divided by 6 whole square minus 13 square is 169 divided by 36 minus 10 by 3 dx. Again, we have to take the LCM of this part. So, dx divided by x plus 13 by 6 whole square minus 36 upon 169, 12 into 3 is 36. So, 12 into 10 minus 120 equal to 1 divided by 3 integral dx divided by x plus 13 by 6 whole square minus 36 upon 289 and 36, the fraction, its square root is 17 by 6. So next line, equal to 1 divided by 3 into integral of dx divided by x plus 13 by 6 whole square minus 17 by 6 whole square. Now, the x plus 13 by 6 is to be given as t. So, let us give x plus 13 by 6 as t. Differentiating with respect to x, 1 equal to dt by dx, or dx is equal to dt. Now let us make the change here, equal to 1 by 3 integral of dt divided by t square minus 17 by 6 whole square. Now let us take the formula, integral of 1 divided by x square minus a square dx equal to 1 by 2a into logarithm of x minus a divided by x plus a plus c. This formula we are going to substitute here. So, equal to 1 divided by 3 integral, you will get the answer. I'll write once more, dt divided by t square minus 17 by 6 whole square. We can write 1 by 3 into 1 by 2 into a. In the place of a comes 17 by 6. Then comes logarithm of mod x minus a. So t minus 17 by 6 divided by t plus 17 by 6 plus c. Then 3 into 2, 6. This 2, 3 and 6 will get cancelled. You will get 1 by 17 into logarithm of, in the place of t, we can substitute what? X minus 13 by 6. X plus 13 by 6 minus 17 by 6 divided by x plus 13 by 6 plus 17 divided by 6 plus c equal to 1 by 17 into logarithm of, taking LCM, you will get 6x minus 4 divided by 6x plus 30 plus c. Now you can divide numerator and denominator by 2. So you will get 1 divided by 17 logarithm of 3x minus 2 divided by 3x plus 15 plus c. Again there is a 3 common. So you can take 1 by 17 logarithm of 3x minus 2 divided by x plus 15. Then comes one additional plus 1 by 17 into logarithm of 1 by 3 plus c. This both constant can be renamed again by a constant c1. So equal to 1 by 17 into logarithm of 3x minus 2 divided by x plus 15 plus c1, where c1 is equal to 1 by 17 logarithm of 1 by 3 plus c. This is the answer.
Okay.
Now let us do integral of the type 1 by root of ax square plus bx plus c dx. Okay, so question, integral 1 by root of 5x square minus 2x dx. The same method as before, you have to make this a perfect square. Before that, you have to make the coefficient of x square 1. So this 5 has to be taken outside the root. So it is equal to integral of 1 divided by this root of 5 into x square minus 2 by 5 x dx. Then next, you can take this root 5 outside, 1 by root 5 into integral of, to make the perfect square of this one, you have to take half of 2 by 5. Half of 2 by 5 is 1 by 5. So 1 divided by root of x square minus 2 by 5 into x. Half of 2 by 5 is 1 by 5. Its square has to be added and subtracted. So plus 1 by 5 whole square minus 1 by 5 whole square dx. So next line, we will write this part is a perfect square. So equal to 1 divided by root 5 into integral dx divided by root of, this is x minus 1 by 5 whole square. So x minus 1 by 5 whole square minus 1 by 5 square. Again, after reaching here, we have to give x minus 1 by 5 as t. Let us give x minus 1 by 5 as t. So differentiating with respect to x, 1 equal to dt divided by dx, or dx is equal to dt, equal to 1 by 5 integral dt divided by root of t square minus 1 by 5 whole square will come. Now, again we will take a formula for here, which is integral of 1 by root of x square minus a square dx, which is equal to logarithm of x plus root of x square minus a square plus c. This formula is substituted here. So, in the place of x comes t, in the place of a comes 1 by 5, equal to 1 by root 5 into integral. We are using the formula, this one, logarithm of modulus of t plus root of t square minus 1 by 5 whole square plus c, equal to 1 by 5 root 5 into logarithm of, instead of t we are going to give x minus 1 by 5. So x minus 1 by 5 plus root of x minus 1 by 5 whole square minus 1 by 5 whole square plus c. So finally, equal to 1 by 5 root 5 into logarithm of x minus 1 by 5 plus root of 5 x square minus, here comes 5 x minus 1 by 5 whole square plus 1 by 25 plus c. This is the answer. One more example of the same type. Integral 1 divided by root of 7 minus 6x minus x square dx, equal to integral of 1 divided by root. This has to be made a perfect square. So first take the negative sign outside. So taking negative x square plus 6x, the remaining 7 is written here. Now this has to be made perfect square. So half of 6, which is 3, its square has to be added and subtracted. So I am adding here 3 square is 9. So actually it is minus 9 to give balancing plus 9 and dx. Okay. Equal to 1 divided by root of, then comes 9 plus 7 makes 16, minus x plus 3 whole square dx. Now this x plus 3 has to be substituted as t. So x plus 3 equal to t. So 1 equal to dt by dx, and dx will be equal to dt. So substituting that here, you will get equal to 1 divided by integral 1 divided by root of 4 square minus t square, and here comes dt. So we are going to use the result again. The formula, integral 1 by root of a square minus x square dx, which will be equal to sine inverse of x divided by a plus c. Copying that here, it will be equal to answer sine inverse of t divided by, the in the place of x comes here t. So, in the place of a comes here 4 square. So, sine inverse of t divided by 4 plus c. But t was x plus 3. So, sine inverse of x plus 3 divided by 4 plus c. This is the answer. Okay, thank you. The next part will be continuing in the next video.